हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर सेफ एट होम. स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न जीके यूनिट नंबर 3 साइंस. सो नाउ लेट्स गोइंग टू लर्न इन डिटेल अबाउट यूनिट 10. नंबर 1, प्लांट्स, PLANTS. सो यू ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद plants and you know what is plant. So here we can see a photograph of plants and also soil. So you all know about plants. So plants absorb nutrients and water through their roots, but photosynthesis, the process by which plants create their fuel, occurs in the leaves. So plants get water from its roots, and also therefore the plants need to get fluids and the nutrients from the ground up through their streams to their parts that are above ground level. So plants get water from the roots, and you know that the plants are good for us because they give oxygen, and also the roots of nutrients and water absorb their roots. And here we can see a demo or photograph of plants and also a plant's roots. So here we can see water and the plant's roots get water from the their roots. So plants get water from the roots. Here we can see photograph of roots and also a water, and here we can see a soil. So plants get water from the roots. So children, you understand about plants. So now we are going to learn next slides and what is the plant. So what is a plant? Members of the plant kingdom share several characteristics. First, nearly all plants are autotrophs, organisms that produce their own food. So, plants produce their own foods, and all plants are equatoids that contains many cells, and all plants cells are surrounded by the cell walls. So here we can see a cell marble, cell wall, and the nucleus and the single plant cell. So plants is the member of the plants kingdom, share several characteristics. And plants need air. What is plant need? So plants need air, plants need water, and plants need sunlight, and plants need soil. So the four types of things plants need to grow. So plants need to grow air, plants need to grow soil, and the plants need to grow water, and also plants need to grow sunlight. So these four things are important for plants growing. So children, you all are understand about how to plants growing. Very good. So now next, parts of plants. So here we can see some parts of plant. So it's the seed. So here we can see a photograph of seeds. So these are the most important parts of the plants found in the fruits and grow into new plants. So seeds are we can found in fruits and then we it's grow into a new plants, then roots. So here we can see a photograph of roots. So usually underground, roots are usually underground and soaks up water and minerals from the ground. So they get water and minerals from the ground. So roots are very important parts of the plants because used to roots they get water. Okay, now next stream. So streams are the very most important part. It is streams. Here we can see a photograph of streams. So streams hold up the plants. Stream hold up the plants and carries water and sugar through the plants. So streams is carry water and sugar through the plants and hold up the plants. And then leaf. So here we can see a photograph of leaf. So leaf is food factories of the plants and make a sugar for the plants to eat. So leaf is a very most important part of the plants because using the sugar for the plants to eating, a root is most important character. So children, you all are understand about parts of the plants. And then next parts of the plants, then last flowers. So here we can see a photograph of flowers. So flower is pretty and blossom. So sometimes make a fruits like a tomato. So tomatoes is tomato flowers is making fruits. So the flowers are also a important parts of the plant. So children, you all are understand about the parts of the plants. Very good. So now we are going to learn a next slide. It is a compass. So here we can see a photograph of compass. So compass is a sailor used to compass to find north, or it is a instrument that we can find our north and south. So the compass is the tool that show the direction of north, south, east and west, and has magnetic needle and which always points north. Because of the earth's magnetic field or the force that pulls, so compass were the first invented by the Chinese in the 1100 and were used for navigation for ships and declining were to build cities. So sailors used to compass to find north. Mostly sailors used to compass to find north. So compass is a show direction and the north, south, east and west, and also it is a magnetic needle, and the earth's surface is magnetic field or force that it pulled. So you all understand about the compass. So now we are going to learn a railway track. So here we can see a photograph of railway and railway track. So the distance between the two track is measured from the center of one track to center of another track. So it is a 15 feet or 6 inch in the broad gauge in the extending track. So a small gap is left between the rails of the railway track so that the track is central or other track. It is a exchanging track for a new works. It should be a capped 5300 mm. Now if you want to know the clear gap between the two tracks, so the gap is left between the rails to provide a space for the iron metal to expand and the central during the summer and winter season due to the change in the temperatures. If the gap is not left in between, then the rails will be bent more and causes derailing of the train. And that's why the small gap left between the two railway tracks. So children, you all are understand why it is a gap between the two railway track? Because a temperature change during the season, and it's a contact during the summer, and iron metal is expanded. So the railway track between the gap. So now next, and it's a direction. So here we can see a four direction: north, east, south and west. So there are four direction: north, south, east and west. So direction are most important things in our country or also in our life, because the four central direction or cardinal points are the direction north, east, south and west. So there are four direction: north, east, south and west, and it is commonly denoted by their intelligence N, E, S and W. So east and west are perpendicular at the right angle and to the north and south, with east being in the clockwise direction. So north and south east are the clockwise direction of rotation from the north, and west being a directly opposite. So the each of the four direction, east, south, west and north, is typically responded by the distinctive colors such as black, red, yellow and white. So which for some stands for the human races, the direction can also respect stage of life, breed, youth and adult or the elder or death. So the each of the four direction, each east, south, west and north, is typically responded by the distinctive colors and such as a black, red, yellow and white. So the direction is central point, four direction is the central points is east, west, east, south and west, north, east, south and west, and it is a symbol NESW. So the direction is most important things in the world. So children, you all are understand about the directions. Now we are going to learn the sun. So the earth is gets its light from the sun. So the sun is the main source of lights. You all know that sun is the main source of the lights, and the heat and the light from the sun is help to plants and animals grow. So sunlight, it is a main important source to the human beings or all living beings. So plants and the animals are also grow by the sunlight, and although the sunlight has many good effects on us, so the earth is also gets sunlight from the sun, and one should not expose himself or herself to the sun too much. So sun is the main source of the lights on the earth. So here we can see a photograph of sun. So sun is the main source of the lights on earth. So it's a very beautiful thing that sun is the main source. Without sun, we have no light. So sun is the nearest star from us, and it is a continuously emitting huge amount of the heat and light. So the sun is the source of almost all energy on the earth, and in fact the sun is the main source of the heat and light for all the plants and planets, and the sun is the heated of our solar system, and 8 planets orbit the sun. So sun is the nearest star from us, and it is a continuously emitting huge amount of the heat and light to give us. And the sun is the source of almost all energy and on the earth. In fact, the sun is the main source of heat and light for the all planet. Okay, now children, you all are understand about sun. Now small planets. So small planets is through they are smallest. These planets are the only ones that have a surface in order of size. They are Earth, Venus, Mars and Mercury. A couple of years ago, Pluto was also considered a planet and was the 9th planet of the solar system. However, Pluto is now considered a dwarf planet. So here we can see a small planet. So they are small planets are Pluto, Europa, Titan, Neptune, Jupiter and the Uranus. So they all are small planets. So planets are also important in galaxy. So here the planets are a large neutral objects that orbit or travel around the star. 8 planets orbit the star called the sun, and the other order from the closest to the sun. These planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So children, you all are understand about the planets. So now we are going to learn a candle. So here you can see the picture of candle. So it is not possible to burn candle if there is no oxygen. So it's true that oxygen need to burn candle. So all the lights a candle makes come from the chemical reaction known as a combustion in which the wax. So Candle is made up from the carbon atoms, chemical typically divided from the petroleum. So reacts with the oxygen in the air to make a colorless gas called the carbon dioxide. So a candle is, when you burn a candle, you end up with the less wax often burning that you started with, because the wax oxidized on the burns in the flame to yield water and the carbon dioxide, which dissipated in the air around the candle. In the reaction, that also yield light and the lights and heat. So it is not possible to burn candle. There is no oxygen. Okay, now next eyes. So here we can see a photograph of eyes. So eyes is the common name of for a frozen water or other liquids such as ammonia or methane or milk could be called ice when they freeze, but they are called milk ice. For instance, instead of just ice, liquid water becomes a solid ice when it is very cold. The freezing point is 0 on Celsius, and when water gets extremely cold, it changes its form and turns from the liquid. So to the soiled water take up more space to the it freezes. As the water changes to ice, the expand and the pushes the lid of the container. So ice is a same size and also a same weight when it is turned into water. Okay, now next earth temperature. So here we can see a photograph of earth temperature. So when it is a global warming is a unusually rapid increases in the earth average surface temperature over the past century, primarily due to the greenhouse gases released as people burn fossil fuel. So as earth moved out of ice ages over the past million years, the global temperature rose a total of the 4 to 7 degrees Celsius over about 5,000 years. In the past century alone, the temperature has climbed 0.7 degrees Celsius, roughly 10 times faster than the average rate of ice as recovery warming. So, and the temperature of the earth has increased in last 200 years. So now the next, and it is a mountain. So here we can see a photograph of mountains. So a mountain is a large landform that rises above the surrounding land and the limited area. So mountains are cooler than the plains because they are higher, and usually it is from the peak. So mountain is generally considered to be steeper than a hill, and mountain are formed through tectonic forces or volcanoes. These forces can locally raise on the surface of the earth. So what are the mountains? So a landform that reaches a high elevation. So for the hill or mountain to be classified as a mountain, its summits or highest point must be more than few hundred meters above the land around it. So you all are understand about mountain, because mountain are a high and that's why they are cooler than the plains. So now P planets. So here we can see a planets. So the planets are around the sun. So here we can see a photograph of planets and the sun. So all planets is around the sun. And the axis is invisible line around which object rotate or spins. Earth, planets, our solar system rotates on its axis. So each planet has a north and south pole, and the points where the axis meets the planet's surface. So all the planets is around the sun, and also there are around its axis. So there are several factors that affect the weather on the planets and the state of the planet's axis, which causes the season, the shape of the orbit around the sun. So all the planets are around the sun. And then next and last, climate. So what is the climate? So climate describes the average weather of a particular parts of the world at different times of the year. So the climate of the place changing in a climate of the place is change in mostly not daily. So in Britain, was would expect cool summers and mild winters with a moderate rainfall throughout the year. So here we can see weather is the day to day or hour to hour change, and the atmosphere and the changing is weather can affect our mood and life. So we wear a different clothes and different things in different weather conditions. So we choose a different foods and different season, like ice cream in the summer, nuts and berries in the autumn, and the hot chocolate in the winter. So the weather is the most important. The climate of the place changing. Climate is changing. Some weather is a long term, and it's called a climate. So here we can see some climates photograph. So children, you all are understand about the science unit number 10, and its name is science. So now we are going to learn some exercise. For each statement, write T for true and F for false in the circles given. So you all are right with me. Number one, plants get water from the air. So it's a true or false? It's a false. Plants get water from the root. So that's why it's a false. Okay, now number two. Sailors used to compass to find north. So it's a true or false? Yes, it's the true. Sailors used to compass to find the north. And the number three, a small gap is left between the rails of the railway track so that the tracks can be cleaned properly. So it's a not true. It's a false. Okay, now number four. There are five main directions. So there are five main directions? No, it's a false. There are four main directions: north, south, east and west. Number five, the earth gets its light from the moon. So earth get light from moon? No. We get light, or earth get light from the sun, and that's why it's a false. And now number six, small planets are called a satellite. No, it's a false. Okay, now next, It is not possible to burn a candle if there is no oxygen. So it's a true. Oxygen need to burn a candle. And then number 8, ice is heavier than the water. So it's a false, because it's a water is frozen, and that's why it called a ice. Okay, now number 9, the temperature of the earth has increased in last 200 years. So it's a true. And then number 10, mountains are cooler than the plains because they are higher. So it's a true, because they are higher and that's why they are cool. And number 8, the fixed path of the planets around the sun is called axis. So it's a false. Okay, now number 12, and last, the climate of the plains change daily. So it's a flow of fair. False, because the weather are changing daily, not climate. So you all are enjoy, very good. Hope you all are learn and enjoy this lecture. So students, I will see you next time. And also students, don't forget to wash your hand regularly, eat healthy food, stay home and stay safe. Thank you students.